יש עתיד, הוא כבר כאן, יש עתיד, כי הגיע הזמן.
While Livni called for the three-way effort and Shelly Yechimovich of Labor has committed to not joining a Netanyahu government, Yair Lapid has been the least enthusiastic of the three to making any commitments and has downplayed the overnight meeting of the three. We asked Yesh Atid candidate Rabbi Dov Lipman why the lack of enthusiasm.
Yesh Atid was not established as a party with its one goal to topple or to unseat Prime Minister Netanyahu. While there's no question we think that he has been a poor prime minister and has not addressed the burning issues within Israeli society and the middle class, our goal was not to unseat him. Our goal is to move our agenda forward. And, you know, we're being realistic and we're 2 weeks before the elections, and every poll that we've seen indicates that at this point in time, Prime Minister Netanyahu is going to be the one asked to form the government, form the coalition. So we're being very pragmatic about it, and we're saying, instead of suggesting that our goal at this point is to somehow find a way to unseat him, which if you add up the numbers doesn't really work anyway, let's try to find a way to work together with him to move together with our issues in terms of the next government and move forward with our agenda.
Even though you're right and your party leader Yair Lapid is right that the polls are certainly showing that it would indicate that Netanyahu would be the one to form the next government, don't you think it's a defeatist attitude to act now as though that's a foregone conclusion?
So a few things. First of all, we are more than ready, if necessary, to sit in the opposition and build ourselves from there and fight against a coalition which Netanyahu might form. But I don't think it's defeatist. Like I said before, our goal was to form a party which can really represent middle-class Israel and, you know, overall education and get equality in national service and housing reform, electoral reform, all these pressing issues. And we will work with the government, any government, that will move forward with those ideals, and we won't if they won't. It definitely has to be a concern for any leader in Israel to see ourselves the possibility of Netanyahu forming a government which is, you know, very extreme in nature, both in terms of the right-wing nature and in terms of the religious nature. And if we're able to step in and form a moderate government together with him and move forward with that agenda, I don't think that's defeatist. I think that's a big success.
Okay, now you are a rabbi, but on the other hand, as you say yourself, you have fought against the fact that there are Haredim in particular who do not serve in the army or do some form of national service at least. But do you feel uncomfortable, Rabbi Lipman, with the fact that Yair Lapid is saying what he is saying to Hatzinua and Labor, let's work together so that, as you just said yourself, Dov, that Mr. Netanyahu, if he in fact does form the next government, does not need the religious, does not need the right. Do you feel a little uncomfortable with that attitude?
I feel no discomfort whatsoever. First of all, while it's true that we made a call to Hatzinua and to Labor to join together with us to join the government, make a national unity government, you know, the elections haven't been held yet, and we'll see what happens on the late night January 22nd. It could be that we'll have enough seats, and hopefully we'll have enough seats, that we don't even need to work together with the other parties to make this happen. In terms of your question about religious parties, I personally, as a rabbi, as somebody religious, I have a big problem with the whole notion of religious parties. I think that religion and politics don't mix. You can have religious people involved in politics, but the idea of a religious party looking out for its narrow interests instead of what's best for the entire country, I think is very damaging to religion, and I think it's time for religious people in Israel to shift away from that and work together with broader Israel to make the necessary changes and really move the country forward.
And in one word, on the issue of, let's say, the Palestinians, you don't think Hatzinua and Labor is too far to the left for you?
We're definitely different in terms of the fact that we don't view our goal here as rushing to make some kind of an agreement. We definitely view it as something which we have to explore and be practical about it and pragmatic about it and take Israel security into effect. But if we're talking about it to get Netanyahu government anyway, given the very right-wing nature of the coup d'etat at this time, I don't think we'll be in a government where we're rushing very far to the left. I think it'll be very much center, which is very much who we are.
Yesh Atid Knesset candidate Rabbi Dov Lipman.
יש עתיד, הוא כבר כאן, יש עתיד, כי הגיע הזמן, יש עתיד של הבוחים, יש עתיד אם רק נחליט.